I feel like the hardest part of my program. Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's your girl Naysha. And I'm back with a video, and today is Valentine's Day, so happy Valentine's Day. So today I'm just gonna be vlogging a little get ready with me for my Valentine's Day date night. Yeah, and it is 12:30 right now, and I feel super duper lazy because I spent 10 hours doing my hair yesterday. Doing knotless braids, but I'll show y'all later on when I don't have my hat on. I have to do a few running around, so stay tuned for, I don't know what to call it. Just stay tuned. Now that that's done, one thing I don't like about brand new box braids is that the first day it'd be so stiff, but like, I'm gonna start to get ready. I'm gonna do a little workout and then I'm gonna get ready. But tell me why I woke up with a big pimple on my forehead that I have to... Too much information, but why on Valentine's Day? But yeah, I'm about to get ready. I'm about to eat, work out, then get ready. Okay, guys. I showered and everything. I semi know what I want to wear tonight because the outfit I originally had planned is a dress and heels with my toes exposed, but it's cold outside, so I'm like, I don't know if it's a good idea anymore. And it's in Manhattan, so you have to, you know, walk to your destination because, you know, parking is crazy. So I don't know, I might just have to end up wearing boots with it, which I really dislike because the heels are so pretty, but I don't know what I'm doing about that yet. I definitely know I'm wearing the dress still that I ordered. But yeah, I'm gonna do my makeup. I just washed my face. I'm not really crazy into makeup, so please don't come for me if I'm not doing it right. This is just the way I do it. This is just the way I do it. Priming my face first because skin was mad dry, even though I just moisturized it. But while I do this, I want to talk about some nursing stuff. I know I said I made this channel to share my nursing journey, but I feel like I didn't really tell you guys what my journey was like. So I kind of like, while I'm doing my makeup, I kind of want to chat about how I got to this point. And you know, I feel like social media makes it so, you know, glamorous of how you finish nursing school, you straight in, and that's it. Like, no one really talks about like the upside downs and the problems and the downhills you face getting into nursing school and actually being in nursing school. I'm gonna talk about that first. Yeah. Just ignore any makeup that I'm doing. Please don't judge me. I'm gonna find a way, and if it looks good, I just fake it until I make it. So story time of how I got into downstate, or the process of actually getting to where I am now. I attended Stony Brook University, but I didn't know what I wanted to do. I knew going in as a freshman, I wanted to become a doctor, but becoming a Stony Brook student made me realize I don't want to be a doctor and I just want to just care for people. So after a lot of debating on like what route I should go, I finally decided that nursing was the route for me. So I was like, you know what? I like nursing school. I like the sound of nursing school, and the prerequisites are kind of like what my interests were at the time. Like, I like learning about the body. I'm not too much into the physics and the orgo. So I was like, let me just go this route and see if it's like, you know, for me. And I liked the classes, and I was like, I definitely think that I'm gonna, you know, do well in nursing school and actually like the profession. So, you know,
as everybody else that was interested in nursing at Stony Brook, I applied to Stony Brook's nursing school. And I applied as a junior, but you're really supposed to apply as a sophomore, but I didn't have my prereqs yet. So I applied as a junior and got rejected. I applied for the baccalaureate program. I got rejected. And I could see why I got rejected. My personal statement was trash. But you know, I was like, I don't really have much experience. Let me get some experience under my belt. But yeah, I applied junior year and I didn't get in. And it was already hard enough with COVID. I couldn't get any experience at all. Like, I couldn't get any experience. Did I want it to cover it? I didn't get any experience at all. And if I did get experience, it was virtually, which sucks. Sucks OD, because what experience are you getting virtually if you want to go into a clinical setting? I did some internship online through a hospital. And I liked it, but you know, it's not really clinical experience. And I worked as a pharmacy tech over the summer. And with my senior year schedule at Stony Brook, I couldn't transfer stores. I was working at CVS, I couldn't transfer stores. And because of my availability, I was never available. I was probably available like for one shift a week, and they said, nah, there's no point of you working here if we don't want you. So, you know, I had to quit within 3 months, well, resign, because I couldn't, you know, transfer stores near my campus. So that sucked too. Doesn't look good on your resume, but it is what it is, you know. God has a path for everybody, and what will be will be. And you know, it's senior year, so I try applying again to Stony Brook's nursing program. Not just to the baccalaureate program, which is a 2-year program, but I also applied to the accelerated program. And guess what, y'all? I got denied again for both. And I was like, okay, you know, this is God telling me that, you know, it's just not meant to be at this campus. And most importantly, I couldn't even afford it anyways. I would probably have to be taking out loans, which people just, you know, majority of the people who's like applying to graduate school or any nursing programs will take out loans, but you know, it's not something you want to do, but it's just something that, you know, is the last resort. So, you know, after crying about it and stuff, I just realized that it wasn't for me and I just had to accept it. I continue applying to other nursing schools. My spring semester of senior year, and you know, at the top of my list was Downstate, because it was the cheapest program. It was the school that I was most acquainted with because I did summer internships there. It was the school that just made more sense, and it was the cheapest school, and I just kind of liked the fact of me going there because I already knew the campus. So it was at the top of my list. And then a bunch of other schools that was expensive. So at this point, I'm just praying that I got into Downstate. And I got rejected from one other schools out of 5. But I didn't really care about that because it was the most expensive one on the list. So yeah, I went through a heck of a ride applying to these schools while trying to finish my classes. I was taking 6 classes, and I think I was taking like 19 credits while being vice president of a club, and I was losing it. When I tell you, I was losing it. I was so stressed. My blood pressure was spiking. I had just recovered from COVID. I had took the TEAS exams while I had COVID. I mean, I was studying for the TEAS exams while I had COVID, because I had COVID right after Christmas, and I had the TEAS exam the ending of January. So it was like, it was hell. But, and one thing people do not mention, like I said, people don't really tell you about their their downs. They tell you about your about their ups, but not their downs. One thing that that's gotten me through college and the process of applying to nursing school is prayer. I don't think that I am, you know, the smartest out of the bunch. Like, I never thought that way. I've always depended on hard work and prayer to get me through school or whatever hard situation that I can't really handle on my own. And that's what has gotten me to this point. And this is advice to any student, not just nursing school or anything, anybody. If you really want something, pray on it. And don't just ask God for what you want. Like, actually show him that, you know, you appreciate his blessings and stuff like that. Pray every night. And don't just ask him for what you want. Like, actually have a conversation with God and actually find an intimate place to speak with God. So that's what I've been trying to do, and I really feel like he's gotten me through a lot of hardships throughout my pre-nursing journey / nursing journey. So that's definitely a big one. But throughout it all, I believe it was like around March, after submitting my applications in late January, I got a call back from downstate in March for an interview, and the interview went really well, and the next day I found out I was accepted. If that's not God right there, I don't know what is. Like, the next day, come on now. The very next day, I found out I was accepted. And yeah, that is my little journey getting into nursing school. Now, I always thought that, oh yeah, I just need to get into nursing school and my life is set. Who told me that? Like, nursing school is probably the hardest thing I've ever done. Bro, please don't come for me. I don't even know what I'd be doing like that. I am so bad at makeup. Please trust the process, because I promise you, I wouldn't leave my house looking crazy. You know, I just fake it until I make it, for real. Okay, back to the story. Also, another thing that a lot of people don't talk about, which I wish people would talk about more, because I'm pretty sure everyone has experienced this, majority of us at least, is post-grad depression is real, y'all. Like, imagine just working towards a goal and then finally accomplishing it, and then you don't really know what to do after that. I mean, I don't even know if I'm explaining it right, but I think the major change for me after graduation was living with a lot of close friends that I would, you know, see over a lot, and, you know, crack jokes and eat, have lunch or see every weekend, and then to every day just home alone. Not home alone, but just, you know, to no friends and just binging shows on my own. And it's not the same, and it's just like the big shift from on campus to home. Especially me, you know, I don't have any siblings, so it's just, it hit different. Like, I don't know what it was, but I had some type of post-grad depression. It was also like a lot of anxiety symptoms that I was having from applying to nursing school, like just overexerting my body, doing a whole bunch of things at once. But yeah, it has not been easy. From going from every day being busy to just, you know, every day being available. And at this time, This is the biggest advice I'm gonna give y'all. If you are a senior at a university, or you know, you're finishing a program that doesn't really require a license, you guys want to look into license. Like, a degree is nothing if you have no skills to back it up. So if you're interested in the healthcare field and you're about to graduate university in a health science degree or something, you know, that's really general, please, and I tell y'all don't even have to wait until after you graduate. Do it in school. Like, get a license as a medical assistant, CNA, it don't matter, just get a license. Like, the amount of experience you could gain while getting under your belt is crazy, and that's something I really regret. I was like, yeah, I'm not gonna be a CNA, I don't want to be doing that stuff, just to, you know, end up doing CNA stuff, a CNA related job that's like not paying me anything. So I really recommend get a license in something, like, and especially healthcare related. You're not gonna get much opportunities without some type of background knowledge, because you're dealing with lives and people's not just gonna hire you like that. You gotta have some type of knowledge. Phlebotomy, EKG, it don't even matter. Have something. Like, that's something I regret so bad. Like, if I could do it over, after college, I would just straight take a course in something instead of applying to a bunch of jobs that doesn't want to hire a new grad with no experience. So yeah, ooh, that's the best advice too. I said this at a high school panel, and this girl, it was like a healthcare panel where like a bunch of people in healthcare fields are talking about their experiences, and I was representing like nursing students. And this girl next to me was a medical student, and I, like, we had 10 seconds to give like one piece of advice to like the high school students, and mine was, get your CNA, if you're interested in nursing, get your CNA license like right now. Like, it don't even, I know it's not a glamorous, you know, job to do, but are you kidding me? You're in nursing school, and especially if you apply to a CNA per diem job, you're just picking up a shift whenever you want, and the amount of money they get paid goes crazy. And if they, and if it's a 12-hour shift, you only gotta work like what, one 12-hour shift a week if things get really stressful. Like, that compared to what I'm doing, shoosh, I should have just did a CNA job. But yeah, I don't really know how to get into, you know, the whole nursing school thing. Like, everybody's journey in nursing school is going to be different, especially if they're going to different schools. I want to say that compared to other schools, I really don't think my nursing school was that terrible. Like, I feel like it was like they worked with you. If you're not doing good, they'll work with you. They're not gonna kick you out. Like, that's what I like about my nursing school. Some nursing schools, if you don't get an 80 day, they're trying to kick you out. Like, that right there is terrifying. My nursing school worked with us, and I really appreciated that. Cause to kick somebody out that's interested in nursing is kind of crazy. Cause aren't we going through a nursing shortage? I know, like, we're dealing with lives here, but what's gonna happen if there's no one to take care of them lives? Then what we do now? Patients gonna be ringing call bells, and there's gonna be no nurses to come. Like, I just think that's kind of crazy. If someone isn't doing well in school, you know, you kind of guide them, don't kick them out. But yeah, I feel like any nursing school you go to is going to be hectic. It's going to be chaotic. I feel that in my bones. Like, it's not going to be glamorous at all. Every nursing school has its issues,
And there's always two sides to the story. I feel like people's always quick to blame staff for not being organized, but you know, you can only work with what you got. And if they don't have the funds to, you know, to really give the resources that they want to give, it's gonna be unorganized. So
they don't look the same. Why does one have an arc and one doesn't? Yo, what are we doing right now? This is why I don't be wearing makeup, because when I try to do it, it be looking mad weird.
I have to blend this out properly.
We gonna come back to the eyebrow situation. I wanted to do my eyebrows, but we got snowed in yesterday. You know what I think it is? I think I shaved off a piece of my eyebrow. I got snowed in yesterday, so I decided to do my own eyebrows. And I think right here, I kind of overcompensated. I had worse, so I'm not gonna complain. I had half of my eyebrow shaved off by a makeup artist once, so I'm not complaining. Never gonna complain, like, life could always be way worse. Let's be honest right now.
But guys, let me tell you a little bit about my nursing program, like their curriculum.
Well,
it's not my nursing program anymore, I graduated. So my nursing program is accelerated for 2 months. I have 4 semesters of nursing school. It finished in December. So I started last August and I finished this December of 2023. I seen a girl on TikTok do this. If you guys don't know what this is a lash extension, blow dryer, whatever you want to call it. Them dryers, the lash types we're using, yeah. This is what this is. I feel like it's so good for makeup. I feel like the hardest part of my program had to be the summertime. Summertime was the shortest semester, and the summertime was also the semester they gave us more work. Not more work, but harder classes, in my opinion. The hardest classes, in my opinion. I took OB, pediatrics, med-surg 2, along with an advocacy class in healthcare and informatics. And the big three, pediatrics, labor and delivery, and med-surg, was obviously the hardest. In the shortest semester, it was torture. There was probably about 2 to 3 exams each week. But I somehow got through that summer okay. Like, the amount of sacrifices I had to make, yeah, cool, because it's summertime. But my mental health was honestly not that terrible. But after the semester after, which was my last semester of nursing school, which was, you know, August to December of 2023, that had to be the worst my mental health has been throughout the program, besides the first semester. The first semester is always hard because you have to adjust to a new program. I was just so burnt out. Like, my anxiety was terrible. It wasn't healthy at all. I'm just glad to be done with nursing school. I never want to do that ever again. But yeah, that's just a little bit about my nursing school journey. I am currently preparing to take the NCLEX, and the date is slowly approaching. Not slowly, fastly approaching. I'm kind of nervous. It's a lot of pressure here. It's a lot of pressure. Especially when some people already know my exam date. It's just like, now I feel like I need to pass on the first try.
But yeah, now you guys kind of know some of my nursing journey, some of my pre-nursing journey, and I will continue to talk about it more once I'm fully a nurse, because then I could really, you know, the purpose of me making this channel was to, you know, I went through a lot of curveballs and a lot of stress trying to just finish off my prerequisites, finish college, finish nursing school. The whole application process is a different stress. Like, so the purpose of this channel was to just, you know, kind of share my experiences so other people could avoid those stresses. So I just want to, you know, be a guiding stone and help others, essentially. That is the purpose of this channel. And, you know, if you're not a nursing student or if you're not a college student, you know someone who is, you know, feel free to share it, because I really just do want to help people. Like, I feel like that's why I went into this profession. I just like helping people. Something y'all don't know about me, I'm like probably the clumsiest person in this world, this whole world. Like, the craziest things just be happening to me out of the blue. I don't know what it is. I don't know how I freaking shaved my eyebrow like that, but it's crazy. It's real crazy to me. I'll be back with the finished look. I might. No promises. Okay, y'all. I'm finally ready. And I have the finished look. Then my makeup. Kind of styled my hair. Just put it in an up and down style. Just two little braids in front. I'm dressed and I'm just waiting now. I'm going to try to show y'all my whole fit, but this tripod is not trying to position right. So this is the fit. I finally figured out a way, even though my head is like cut off. This is the fit. And then the shoes, the purse, a little razzle dazzle for the nails. It's just press-ons. I don't really like acrylics because I want my nails to come off the next day. Not the next day I dragged it, but like the next week. This is the fit. Apologize for the towel on the bed, but thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video because it was very chaotic and over the place. I apologize for that, but thank you for watching the video. This is how my makeup turned out. I ain't never no makeup artist, but I don't know, I don't think it looks too bad. You know, fake it till you make it. That's my motto of the day. But yeah, a little DIY here and there. Did my own hair, press-ons, you know, did a little something with the makeup. But yeah, thank you guys for watching this video. Bye.